Grade 11, trigonometry. This applies to pre-calculus and applied math. So grade 11, trigonometry, ambiguous triangles. Ambiguous triangles. Gotta love them. Ambiguous. What does ambiguous mean? I didn't check it out in a dictionary, but it means, not sure, you're not sure, you got conflicting answers. Right, so there you go. If you're not sure, you got conflicting answers, we'd say that things are ambiguous. So you can have, in a triangle, sometimes you'll end up with two possible solutions to a triangle. So sometimes in a triangle, there are two answers to a corner angle. So let's have an example here. I'm thinking of a triangle. Here's the triangle. Okay, so it's got a 30-degree corner. A side next to that corner of 10, and a side across from that 30-degree corner of length 3 units. Draw that triangle. Well, it looks something like that there, eh? There's a 30-degree angle of two lines. You're told the length of that line, and the side across, you're told that's a 3. There you go. I just drew it. Right, that was easy. Pretty easy, right? Okay, unfortunately, there was another possible answer. So this one would have worked too. Boom, boom, 30. And the 10 would be there, but look, now the 3 would come inwards from the end of the 10. So both of those would satisfy the description of that triangle. There's two possible answers. And we call that ambiguous. So notice there's two possible answers with a side 10, a side 3, and a corner here of 30. And it turns out that's two different triangles. Notice this corner here is obtuse and this corner here is acute. So they're not the same triangle. But they both satisfy what we said. They're lengths of sides and angles. Right, let's have a look at an example of an ambiguous triangle. So here's a triangle that's got a 40-degree corner and a side 8 length there, and then across from the 40 is a 6, side 6. Right, so let's see what this is going to be. Well, first of all, that's got to be more than 40, doesn't it? Because remember, that side's longer than that side, so it's got to be more than 40. So let's be clear on that, all right? Using the mama bear, baby bear rule. So we set her up there. 6 over the sine of 40 is equal to 8 over the sine of theta. Right? We're going to call that angle theta or theta, depending on how you pronounce it. And survey says bounce some things around there, a little magical solving proportions or cross-multiplying, as they say, if you don't like full algebra. Turns out sine theta is, boom, right there. So you'd calculate it as 0.857. And, of course, the more accurate you can be, the better an answer you'll get in the end. And then, of course, you're going to unsign that. So to unsign it, you did the inverse sign. That's the top part of your button. And it turns out that every triangle where the opposite side is 0.857 one times as long as the hypotenuse, we measured that 1,000 years ago, is going to be a 58.99 degree angle. I'm thinking that's pretty close to 59 degrees. Okay, so let's just say it's 60, just to make it nice and round, okay? So we'll just call it 60. But there's another angle that works, too. Maybe we drew this one wrong. All right? We could have had this 6 hanging inside instead of hanging outside, in which case that would have been a 120-degree angle. Right, and I just rounded to the nearest nickel there. So it turns out that nobody said that 6 had to hang outwards. It could have hung inwards, too. So there was actually two answers. So that corner could either be 60-ish, well, 59, or 121. Okay, let's try again. So we've only studied angles in right-angle triangles, you know, in grade 8, 9, 10. So you haven't really gotten into obtuse triangles or acute triangles. You've always had triangles with square corners in it. But it turns out if I ask you what sign, if I ask what sign has what angle, you say, well, let's try this. All right. If I said, pretend the sine of some angle is 0.4. Well, you could put that in a calculator like that, do the inverse sine. You say, oh, it's a 23.578 degree angle has a sine of 4. So let's call it 23.6. And if I said, what angle has a sine of 0.6? Well, that's where you look it up backwards in the tables, or you use your plastic brain. It says it's 36.9-ish, 36.9 degrees. What angle has a... If I said the sine of the angle is 0.7, what is the angle that has a sine of 0.7? In other words, what is the angle where the opposite is 7/10 as long as the hypotenuse, is what I'm saying, right? That's the shape. That's what I mean. So that angle there, our ancestors measured that thousands of years ago. They told us it was 44.43 degrees. All right, geez, I'm not very good at rounding. Oh, yeah, that's good. All right, so 44.4 degrees. If I go to the nearest tenth. But guess what? Wait, there are other angles that do it too. Watch this. The sine of 156.4 is 0.4. Boom. And the sine of 140.3 is 0.6. Boom. And the sine of 135.6 is 0.7. Boom. So it turns out there's two angles that have a sine of 0.4. It's just you've never had the occasion to study the more obtuse angles, the angles more than 90 before, because you never used a triangle that didn't have a 90 or less. Right? So there are other angles that work. It turns out the plastic brain only tells you one of the proper angles. So a calculator only tells you one of the answers. It only tells you the smaller, more acute angle, the angle less than 90 degrees. So plastic brains aren't all that smart if they only know half of the story. All right, let me show you that again. Let's try it. You try. I'll give you some angles here, and then you pause. All right, so you pause. Now you calculate the sine of 30, scribble it on a piece of paper, the sine of 45, scribble it, you know, offset it to the right a little bit like I've done. You know, so leave a little space in here, you'll see why. You calculate that. Are you on pause? Calculate them now. And here's your results. So hopefully you grabbed a calculator. You filled in the blanks, you're calculating the sine of 30, 0.5, the sine of 45, 0.707, the sine of 60 should be about 0.866, you get these memorized after a while, the sine of 80, oh, that's 0.985, and I don't know these ones, how about the sine of 87, sine of 87, according to the plastic brain, is 0.999, 999 one-thousandths is the proper way to say that, it's pretty close to 1. Sure. Yeah, okay. Now, check out these angles. I'll give you some other angles. We'll call them beta, right? I called these angle theta. Now I'll give you angles beta, right? You have a Greek B. So we like to use Greek letters for angles. So try the beta. So I'll give you a beta and you calculate its sine. And I'm going to give you a beta of, let me see, how about 150? Okay, you do beta of 150 and do beta of, let's say 135 perhaps. And let's try beta of 120. And maybe, how about if I pick another beta of 100? Do you see how I'm getting these? And then maybe I'll pick a beta of, oh, maybe 93. All right. Do you see where I'm getting these from? Look, that adds up to 180, adds up to 180, adds up to 180. 180 is 180, 93 and 87 is 180. Look how that plus that is 180. Well, let's see what these, what the sine of these beta angles is, right? And let's see, let's calculate the sine of the beta angle. And boom, 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 yeah, look at that. It's the same numbers. It turns out that the sine of 30 is the same as the sine of 150. Sine of 60 is the same as the sine of 120. It turns out that if the angles are supplementary, remember how supplement means they add up to 180? So notice that they add up to 180 degrees. So we call those two angles, theta and beta, supplementary, because they add up to make 180 degrees, and they each have the same sine. So don't forget, a calculator only tells you half the story. So that can get you into, you know, the, when you solve a triangle, there might be two answers in some circumstances. Let's have a look at when. Here's a geometric explanation of when you might have two answers. All right, check this out. I got a side here and a side here. And notice this side is longer than this side. So if I'm making this triangle and this side is longer than this side and I want to know this corner, right? I'm told this corner, and I want to know this corner, well, there's two possibilities, right? Nobody said the B had to be hanging outside. It could be hanging inside. So notice that's an isosceles triangle. Notice that when you do this, since that length is the same as that length, then this corner is the same as this corner. So if this corner is the same as this corner, then it means this inside corner of the other ambiguous triangle is 180 degrees less than this corner because it's supplementary. Check it out. It's true. Remember why we studied supplementary angles? So beta has to be 180 minus angle theta. So we say that beta and theta are supplementary. Supplementary. So again, a calculator only tells you half the story. It only gives you the acute angle, not the obtuse angle. So you have to know, well, it helps if I know how to spell. You have to know when there, oh man, don't tell an English teacher, when there is another answer. You have to know when there, and how can you know when there's another answer? Well, the smart way to do it is just sketch it out, right? When you're given a problem, sketch it out in a little better scale. You know, try to sketch it out the way it would actually look. So remember that teachers seldom actually do triangles to scale, but if you were to sort of sketch it out so it's a little closer to what it should look like, that would make a little, that would give you a good clue. So I like to pretend like maybe I got a 12-foot fishing pole stuck in the mud here at an angle, and I'm sitting there eating my sandwich, and maybe it's at a 40-degree angle, and there's 4 feet of fishing line. Right, so where's my fishing pole? There it is right there, 12 feet long. Now, if I've got 4 feet of fishing line, and provided it's kept taut and straight by the current, it turns out, what triangle could I make? Well, the fishing line could be out there, or it could be bobbing around on the inside. But either way, provided that fishing line is straight to make a triangle, it turns out that's an isosceles triangle, so that angle and that angle are the same. That's an isosceles triangle, which means that this angle here is supplementary to this angle. So there's the two possible triangles, the obtuse one and the acute one. So you can anticipate there'll be two solutions, when you have a short side across from a known angle with a another long side. Now, I imagine there's a more mathematical way to say it, but the ambiguity occurs when you're given an angle. So if you know this angle, you know, and two sides, so a length and a length, and the shorter side is across from the angle that you know, then that's a pretty good clue, that provided the triangle actually exists, that you're going to have an ambiguity problem. So which of these have an ambiguity issue? Right, let's try those, try that one. We'll give you a chance to pause. We're looking for which ones of those might have an ambiguity issue. So get ready to pause your machine here. Just touch the screen, touch the movie. Good. So pause. Pause now. So which of these would have an ambiguity issue? Well, this one here would, for sure. Yeah, this one would, because notice you're given an angle here and a long side and a shorter side across from the given angle. So that would give you an issue, because that could actually have the... The 17 could come out on that side, right? There you go. So that could give you an issue. Oh, I shouldn't have shown all my cards yet. All right. So that first one here, that would give you an issue. So some ambiguity would definitely exist in that first one. So yes, ambiguity. Bing. And there's the other possible solution right there. How about this one here? Do you think there's any ambiguity there? No, I don't think so, eh? Because look, you got an 80, you got to give an angle, and you've got a side next to it and a side across. But this is a long, this side's longer than that side. All right, so there's no ambiguity involved there. How about this one here? No, there's no ambiguity there. In fact, since that side's the same length as that side, it's isosceles, so that... That was a fishing pole of 8 long, and that was a line of 8 feet. Guess what? That's the only configuration of triangle you could set up and still have a 40-degree corner down here. Right? So there's no ambiguity issue there, because that is not shorter than that. It's the same. Next slide. Or next one. How about this one? Nope. Notice this says here's a 100-degree angle, and you got a long side across from it. And you got a short side there. So since it doesn't have a short side across from the 100-degree angle, you know that it's not going to have an ambiguity problem. Now, of course, right away, you should notice that, by the way, this is not a very good drawing of the situation, is it? Does that look in any shape or form like a 100-degree angle? I don't think so. But you know what? A teacher could just put that on and say, well, that's a 100-degree angle. And then when you look at it, you go, it looks more like 40, right? But don't argue with the teacher, because if he tells you that's 100, you got to go by the numbers, all right? This is why I encourage you to maybe redraw things to scale, maybe. So the way it should have looked more like this, right? There's your 100-degree angle, there's your 30, and there's your 20. Okay? So there's a better, that's a better scale model of what the situation is. There's nothing wrong with this, except that it absolutely looks nothing like what it's supposed to represent, which teachers sometimes do to fool you, all right? This is a better scale model, all right? And notice it's not going to have any ambiguity, right? There's no other way you can arrange those sides with that 100-degree angle, right? You could put that 30 over to that side, but then it wouldn't be a 100-degree angle, right? And you could put that 20 over to there, but then that wouldn't be a 100-degree angle, right? So it turns out that's the only arrangement you could possibly have. Next slide. Where are? Okay. So what's the next diagram there? Is this one going to have any ambiguity? And this one will, of course, because you got an angle and a short side across from it and a long side adjacent to it. So yes, you will have ambiguity because this six or this piece of fishing line could have come in this way. In which case you got that corner or its supplement there as the possible answers. Yeah, pretty intense stuff. What do you know? All right, so it turns out this is what we did. This is when you will have two different ambiguous answers. Okay, so I don't know what the proper explanation is in a mathematical sense, but there's what it is in layman's terms, all right? If you have two sides and a non-included angle, and the shorter side is across from the given angle, then you're a candidate for having an ambiguous triangle, assuming the triangle exists. There are triangles that you can state that don't exist, but we'll talk about that later. And for my pre-cal guys, guess what, pre-cal? Some of you might like to see your angles as a graph instead. So here's a reason why, for pre-cal guys only who learn how to graph this stuff. And actually, you'll do this in grade 12 applied as well. All right, but in applied math, you'll learn how to graph stuff. And it turns out, here's a graph of the sine of an angle. So if we call the x-axis the angle, and the up and down the sine, there's what it looks like when you graph the sine of an angle, and we'll call it theta. And if we make the top maximum 1, and then it bottoms out at negative 1, like a regular sine. So if I said when, at what angle, has a sine of 0.5. So what angle has a sine of 0.5? Remember how a calculator only tells you the one angle? A calculator says that the answer is 30. It forgets to tell you it. The calculator tells you this answer right here. At 30 degrees, it's 5. The calculator forgets to tell you that there's another place where it's 5 when it comes back down. So there's two answers, 130 and 150, where the sine of the angle is 0.5. For a triangle, at least. For a circle, there's an infinite number, of course, because this sine curve wobbles on and on forever. But for a triangle, there's two answers, 30 or 150, where the sine of an angle is 0.5. So I think that was it. Are we in there? All right, so that's what ambiguous triangles were all about. Complete.